we don't have get so much fact, but I think it will be fun. Well, we will stay outside, I have heard, but I'm sure, so I think that will be fun.
Yes, we have to build our shells and everything. I think it's going to be hard.
So you don't know where you are?
No, I don't know.
Uh-huh.
Oh my god. Do you know who where we are?
Yes.
Can you show me on the
no.
map? Why?
It's part of the game. So, you are lost?
No.
No.
This lawn here is our campsite. And here we have 7 tents. And you are 28. So how many people in each tent?
4.
So 4 people in each tent.
Don't you have a group, girls? Are you not in a tent group? You don't know.
The positive effect will be definitely that they will feel not disturbed in what they want to do.
So you found a solution?
Yes.
How?
Luck.
While you're here, you are going to do all the cooking from now on yourself.
And they will learn a lot from acting their self instead of just joining into activities all the times.
So all of you now have a bike, more or less. There's only a couple who have a little difficulties with the bikes, but they will learn during the week, so don't worry about that.
But she,
come on, you can do it.
Have to fall down.
Yeah.
To
easy.
Feeling the floor a bit.
To know how to drive a bicycle.
And you have to, of course, wash up your own things that you use. Okay? Every day.
You know? Youngsters. We need cell phones and internet, and we need friends.
Yeah.
I have a lot of friends,
and
but now
alcohol.
I need my phone. And I need Facebook. It's a very good network.
Yeah, and it's so fucking hard, you
it's
know?
So
when you wake up and you don't know what time it is.
Yes, we don't know what time is it.
And you're hungry and you don't know what time it is. Then, shit.
Everywhere you get the buns.
We will get the proper lunch.
We will get the proper lunch.
No ideas.
I'm full of rubbish everywhere.
I'm here because my English and I'm not so good, and I hope learn some more than I know.
I think the most important thing for me is to get some good friends, new friends.
Learn things about here, the culture of Denmark.
Having fun and party all the time.
Put your hands up in the air! Put your hands up in the air! Put your hands up in the air!
Thank you.
have to do mostly everything. If we want to do something, we have to make it by ourselves. The leader is just here to is just here to support if there are any problems.
Do you speak English?
No. No one can talk in English really, really good. And now we must look on their movements and mimic and so on.
How did you show it to her?
I make it before and then I give her the guitar.
So with your body and with the music?
In the group dynamic processes, you have a lot of informal learning about how to behave and how to socialize.
Please, have you wanna teach me?
This is the first time you work with this material?
Mm-hmm.
Who showed you?
I saw in my class of Joe, my professor do something like this, and I like it, and I want to try.
And now here you can try it.
Yes.
But that is like when you work with clay or with painting, often you reach places in yourself that are not so visible, or that you are not reaching by talking or doing other things, and that can be surprising.
I think many people think it's boring to cook. I don't, but I think many people do. But they have to, because otherwise they won't get any food.
That I'm not very good at cooking, but now I'm a bit better.
How did you organize to buy the food?
We buy it together, and I think we only buy once a day.
One of my roomies said he had bought something earlier in the day, and I was okay, good, nice, and then he showed me what it was, and I got fucking mad because it was sweets and candy. And we, for 2 days ago, we had a deal about not buying sweets and candy.
Il est seulement un vieux homme qui a beaucoup d'argent et qui achète aussi le pain.
Ouais.
So we bought some cookies and some marzipan cake. Yes, and when I told him that we bought something, some sweets, then he was angry and mad, and I don't know why, because he said we don't have enough money.
No, I think we're gonna make them on this on the pan, so they're gonna be, you know, so they can be.
We bought healthy and good food.
Yeah. Why?
Because we like it.
Yeah, it tastes
and
very good. So
from healthy food, you're more, you don't get so fast hungry and from fast food.
But it's so boring to cook because I'm hungry And I need to wait the that's finished, so I can't.
Do we cook tea in there? Or?
Yeah, if you like.
We have tea? No, we have to buy.
We have to buy. Yeah.
And I have learned to cook food outside, and how to use the money we have. We only have 10 euro per person, but that's enough.
Could you describe a typical informal learning process that you observed?
There are so many.
It looks like a rubbish center.
You don't like this?
No. And when the rubbish is in there, are not so many animals.
We can't party all the time and we can't just have fun all the time. We need to do the boring things too.
Why do you feel responsible for this? Because it's not pure rubbish, huh?
No, but it's boring to do nothing.
Oh.
Now we're rich.
Do you have enough patience for this?
Oh yes.
Yeah?
We have a lot of time.
When the cleaning went on, people started talking to each other and it became really nice. And there were some very nice talks around the table. So everybody sort of agreed that this is quite boring work, but it's very nice to sit here.
Everybody else is working, so.
You must work too.
Yes, that's fair.
Ah, that's fair, yeah.
Oh, some of these girls were telling me afterwards that, this is also what my grandmother is used to do. And this kind of work is actually nice because it's something you do together. And I think they sort of realized that, you can do boring work, but you can get a lot out of it because of this getting closer to each other. Yeah.
The fact that it was in the island, for us it was very important. The fact that it was in Anholt, with the collaboration of the people of Anholt, it was really one of the best tools for us for the success of the project.
The people living here, and they are very happy to see us. When we're on the road and bike, they always keep a smile when they see us. And that is very nice of them to meet us like that.
Obviously the workshops that we optionally offered to them were an escapatory for them to learn, but as well to use part of their time that they didn't know how to use it, you know. So for me the informal learning was produced because the different factors that were surrounded the environment that we have created with this project.
How do you feel when you do this?
I feel good, you know. I feel like I'm doing something. You know, I made this shirt. I feel, yeah. I know everything in the store. Just come to me, you know. I know. I feel like that. I like that feeling.
Like what feeling?
The feeling that you know something, that you have responsibility.
That's a good feeling.
It's a good feeling, yes.
I'm very glad to have them, and they were very positive and very active young people. And I think they enjoy what they have done with me.
So that's tomorrow, leaving from the harbor at 7 o'clock, coming back the next morning. So it's many hours, and it's just one person.
I was on the fishing boat at the night and at day. It was a little bit boring and also a little bit fun. And we were out in 17 hours, and we were fishing after lobsters and some other fish. It was fun to sail, but not to fish.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good.
How are you?
Tour de France.
No electronic things. Mm-hmm. How do you think about that?
I love it because when I'm at home every day I sit at the computer and go to Facebook and phone some friends, and it's quite the same every day. And here you have to find some other things to do, and you have to handle with yourself, so it's very good, I think.
We don't have internet, we don't have anything, so that's good because now I realize that I can live without it. Because when I go out or something, I always my phone with me, always. But now I realize that that's not so important.
Without handies or iPod or something else, they must use the time in other way, and then the people come on and say hi, I'm Jelte, and we can speak together, and I think it's better because now we are one group and not the Italian group and the German group or the Spain group. We are one group, and it's a good feeling.
So if you come back to school, meet your teacher, what would you like to tell him about learning?
Nothing, because my teacher is not a person that you tell about learning.
You stay at school and the teacher says something, and you must learn and you must get it in your head. And here you talk with other people and you want to know something.
And this is the best way to learn. I think it's the best.
In this way we are free to do whatever we want, and we learn things. In the other way, we have to do what they say to us.
In school, it's just in your head, but now you can see it, you can feel it. So you know, yeah, it's better with a project, because in school you are sitting and listening to your teacher, but in the project is how you see it, not how the teacher sees or the book see it, or the facts. Here you can see it by your own.
I will treat the pupils better than I was treated. I will give them a lot of more freedom, in hope of they would learn some more and feel more comfortable, and maybe make some other results that I did, because they didn't have any freedom as I wanted. And you know, I just want to give the kids a freedom they need for, you know, to make a good work or something like that.
I just welcomed our guests and said we are very happy they would come here tonight, and that we are very happy they would come and join us for dinner, in a way to say thank you for all the work that they've done for us here and giving us the opportunity to maybe visit Anhalt in a little different way than we would normally do if we were just coming as tourists.
This food is like heaven, you know. The last few days we have been eating crappy food. I'm so glad, man. I'm so happy. I can't explain it.
The only word is like heaven. I'm so happy and I just want to go home to my mother's cooking, and this reminds me of how lucky I am.
But I think for our kids in the island, it's a very important project, and hopefully it will inspire them to do things like that themselves and get integrated with a lot of nations in things like this.
If you look at the youngsters, again, I would say I think it's very individual what they learn, but they definitely gain skills, all of them, in different variations, from language skills to cooking skills, intercultural skills, learning about the island, the environment and nature in Anholt and so on.
This reflection that the youngsters are taking with them, the ones that were here, is something that they can share at the same time in the environment that they move. Normally they group of friends, in their family, and as well to be aware of what they were doing here. And for me, this is the main impact.
They will see, okay, more camps should be like this. Not so extreme, but with less rules and leaders who are interested in the learning processes and in the characters of the participants.
Are you happy?
Yes.
You are happy?
Yes.
Yes. Are you happy too?
Yes, I'm very happy. Thank you, my friends. I love you.
Woo!
Sorry!
What is that?
My phone.
Yeah.
Yes.
And now? What happened?
Just call my mom, I think. Yeah, why not?
And first thing you do?
I have to call.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
I have to call. I'm so happy right now.
My phone is alive.
Nora, what happened on Anholt and what are your conclusions? Nora.
Ja.
The Anholt Project.
Reiß dich zusammen!
Okay, okay.
What happened on Anhalt?